Hi everyone, welcome back and welcome to my kitchen. I wanted to show you one of my favorite go-to salads that I've been making a ton. I've literally been eating this non-stop this summer, especially as it started getting really hot here and I didn't really feel like cooking on the stove or making anything in the oven. I started making this modified Greek salad and I've been eating it so much that I thought it'd be really cool to show you guys because I'm really into cooking and healthy eating and stuff. And let me know if you like this video and I can do more. So basically, I took elements of a Greek salad but made it a little bit more robust. Now this is a totally vegetarian version. You can make it vegan as well. I will give you a tip on how to make it totally vegan if you're into that. You guys, this is a meal. So this is not just like, oh, it's a little salad. No, this is like, I eat this for dinner. So I like to put a lot of vegetables and I first start off with baby spinach. So this is actually organic spinach. Spinach is packed full with really good nutrients. There's also iron in spinach. I make a bed of spinach and I just do this on a big wide plate. Sometimes I'll do it in a big bowl as well. Put on the sort of Greek salad type of stuff. So that is red tomatoes. So I've got two sliced up tomatoes here, some sliced up cucumbers. So I'm just gonna do one more tomato here because those tomatoes were fairly small. So I'm gonna add one more. I try to just use really seasonal ingredients when I'm cooking. Like right now, tomatoes are really in season in the peak of summertime. So they taste really good and they're really fresh and they're very inexpensive. You guys, vegetables have almost like basically zero calories. So try to, if you are someone who's watching a bit, you know, your caloric intake, make the vegetable part the most abundant part of the meal. So I try to put the big volume of my meal is usually always vegetables. And then I'll add in like fats and proteins and stuff like that. So that's what we've got. So I've got some sliced up onions on the top. I also love adding chickpeas. So this is how the salad gets more robust. This is how I turn it into a meal because chickpeas are also filling. So these are just out of a can and I just rinse them because sometimes they have that a bit of that sliminess on them. So I'll do a couple tablespoons. This is the vegetarian option because this is real feta cheese. If you want to make this vegan, you can either leave off the cheese or try and find a vegan feta cheese. I have tried one and it's absolutely delicious. So, but there's only like one grocery store near me that carries it and I don't always go to that grocery store. Like it's kind of a little bit out of the way. Yeah, that's why I've just got the regular kind, but this is a slightly lower fat. Cheese in general is a lot of calories. So I just get the light one, which is just a little bit reduced in fat. So this is 200 grams. So it's gonna be about a third of this cheese. I just crumble it with my fingers because it disperses it nice and evenly. Olives, so I just have some black olives here. I don't know, five olives. I don't like too many olives. So I have some watermelon here. This is just a big slice and I get one of these melon scoopers. I mean, you can just cut it up into little cubes, but this is just so great because it makes little sort of round cute or balls. Melon balls, and I just do a few of those on top. This is really what makes it so super summery, and I love the contrast of the feta cheese with the watermelon. That is such a delicious combination. Okay, so the next thing I like to add are just some fresh herbs. Now, these are just straight from my garden. If you don't have fresh herbs, you can just use frozen ones or dried ones, that's fine. These are just, I have these in the summer. So I have some fresh basil leaves and I just like to kind of rip them up and put them in between. Then I also have some mint. And you guys, trust me on the mint. I know maybe it sounds weird. This is going to make your salad so zingy. Also, I like to add some dill. And I don't have this in my garden, so I just use the dried dill. This is kind of typical for Greek salad, is the dill. I just make my dressing with lemon juice and a little bit of really good quality olive oils. I use a really good high quality olive oil because that's gonna make a big difference from the flavor. And I just squeeze that over my hand to catch any of the pips One tablespoon like this of oil of any kind is about 100 calories. Keep that in mind, because if you add like, oh, you know, just glugs and glugs and glugs of like olive oil like this, that could be several hundreds of calories that you're adding. A spoon, I'd measure it out. So I do two. And then I just add salt and pepper on top. But just remember, the feta is also salty, so you don't actually need to add a ton of salt. Doesn't that just look freaking amazing? You guys, I'm telling you, this is one of the best things you can eat in the summer. It's so refreshing. It's very robust. You guys, this is like the best summer salad. It's just super tasty. It's super light, full of flavor, and you will be so full after this. It's so good. Oh my God. Absolutely delicious. Okay, so I hope you guys really enjoyed this recipe. I hope you enjoyed cooking with me. Try it out. If you like this salad and you try it, make sure to tag me on social media, on Instagram or on Twitter. My username on there is HelloJuliaGraf, and I would love to see your recreations. Let me know if you want to see more cooking videos. Give this video a thumbs up. Subscribe if you haven't already. And I will see you guys soon. Take care, everyone. Bye.